We're back in Italy once again for another round of the Formula One World Championship. And what a great race is in store for us today here at the oldest circuit on the calendar. Monza hosted its first race all the way back in 1922. With top speeds up to 215 miles per hour and an average lap speed of around 155 miles per hour, Monza's reputation as one of the fastest circuits in the sport is well earned. We have 11 corners on this 3.6 mile track, with the best overtaking chance coming into the heavy braking zone of the Turn 1 chicane. With me today, of course, is Anthony Davidson. Why don't we discuss McLaren? What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, the atmosphere within that team seems very positive at the moment. Everyone seems like they're in great spirits and having a lot of fun doing what they do, and that's definitely contributed to the performances we've seen.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and Valtteri Bottas will line up alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Vettel, Alexander Albon, and Verstappen, Singh, Perez, Ocon, and Kimi Raikkonen, Gasly, Ricciardo, Daniel Kvyat, and Norris, Sainz, Stroll, Romain Grosjean, and George Russell. Magnussen, Giovinazzi, they'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Latifi and Mick Schumacher. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out. Then let's see who can prevail today.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down.
Thank you.
DRS is being enabled this lap. We can use DRS when you are within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Hamilton's in first place. issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them. Our gap to the car in front is 2.7 seconds. The gap to the car ahead is 2.8 seconds. Is in the pits. Mick in the pits. Bottas is stopping now. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. Okay, you're catching the car ahead, but remember, we need to get to the end of the race on these tyres. You're increasing the gap on the car behind by 0.5 per lap. The car behind is gaining on you by 0.5 a lap. If you continue to cut corners, the stewards will give you a penalty. Gap to car in front is 7.8 seconds. 0 seconds. Some information on Albon. They're retiring from the race. Be aware, we expect the grip levels to start falling away soon. Front is 17.0 seconds. keep on him. He might make a mistake. Is lapping faster than us by around 1 second per lap. The gap to the car ahead is 1.8 seconds. There's only one lap of fuel remaining. This is your final lap, final lap of the race. That's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
That's a spectacular victory then, and with it, the championship is secure. It's been a magnificent season, and they thoroughly deserve the cheers of the crowd here today. Tell me, Ant, how did they manage to achieve this win?
I think that smart tyre management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team, and they certainly deserve it. So let's review the updated driver standings. Lewis Hamilton takes the lead of the Drivers' Championship. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
Carlos Sainz certainly wasn't someone to scoff about. His ability to follow race strategies throughout with pinpoint precision has to be commended.
It's another clear win for Mercedes as they managed to secure the Constructors' title. An incredible performance for the whole team. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time? Be sure to join us again as we continue to bring you the latest excitement in Formula One.